video, we will talk about the significant figures, the rules, and some examples. So let's proceed. So significant figures, or sig figs, are the numbers of digit in a value, often measurement, that contribute to the degree of accuracy of the value, and of course, there are rules. So what are the rules? So rule number one, all numbers that are not zero is significant. For this example, 1.436 has four significant figures. Every single one of this digit is significant because they are non-zero numbers. For the rule number two, zeros in the middle of non-zero numbers are significant. For example, 4.003, it has a four significant figures. These two zeros are in the middle of 4 and 3 are two non-zero numbers, so every single digit count as significant. Rule number 3. Zeros after the decimal are significant. For example, 12.000 has 5 significant figures. These 3 zeros are after that decimal place, so every single one of this digit is significant. Rule number 4. Zeros and coefficient in scientific notation are significant. For example, 9.0 times 10 raised to the power of 3 has 2 significant figures. Notice, we have our scientific notation with something being multiplied by a some sort of power. This 9 and the 0 are significant. Rule number 5. Leading or beginning zeros are not significant. For example, 0.005 has 1 significant figures. Looking here, these 3 are leading or beginning zeros. They do not count as significant. Only these 5 count, so there's only 1 significant figures. Rule number 6. Zeros in a large number without a decimal are not significant. Example, 6000 has 1 significant figures. So these 3 zeros are within a large number without a decimal, so they do not count as significant. Only the 6 does. There's only 1 significant figures. So let's take a look with our examples. So 1, 2, 3, 0. How many significant figures does it have? So, the 0 at the right, do we count it? Well, it's like a trailing 0 and there is no decimal point. So, we're not gonna count it. So, therefore, we can only count these 3 non-zero numbers. So, we have 3 significant figures in the first example. For the number 2, how many significant figures does it have? So once again, we don't have a decimal point, so we cannot count with that 0. But what about zeros in between non-zero numbers? So those 0 we can count, so therefore, this problem has 3 significant figures. For the next one, there is a decimal point, so the trailing 0 is counted, and all of the zeros in between 4 and 8 are also counted. So in this example, we're going to have 5 significant figures. For the next one, we do have a decimal point, but there are no trailing zeros. We do have some zeros, but those will not be counted, so only these 3 digits will be counted. So there's 3 significant figures in that number. For the next one, we do have a trailing zero, which will be counted. The leading zeros will not be counted, so there's only 4 significant figures. Now in the next number, 5020.0, we have a decimal point, so all of the trailing zeros will be counted, and the zeros between 5 and 2, that's always counted. So we have a total of 5 significant figures. So for the last example, all of the zeros in between the non-zero are counted, and since we have a decimal point, the 0 to the right is also counted. So everything is counted in this example. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 significant figures for this problem. So I hope you learned something in this video. Thank you and God bless.
Welcome.